So we're on our first day of CK session, her retouch session. It's been a pretty amazing one, I would say. I've been able to see a person begin to open up and grow and gain courage. So I'd like to ask you, what's the experience been like for you?
It's been completely opposite of what I thought it was going to be for a first day. Challenging, but in good ways. And I like how we take our time, so.
What have you learned about yourself to this time?
I need to learn how to breathe. take time for myself more.
What does that look like, to take time for yourself?
Pay attention to the way I breathe. Take care of myself. Stopping and taking time. Kind of like I get to be selfish in a way, but not in a bad way. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What's one activity that you feel like was the most enjoyable for you?
The objects. But because that taught me how to, I'm opening up a whole new realm of, I don't pay enough attention to myself. But then describing, and the fact that it wasn't just hard or soft or whatever, it actually triggered something emotionally. Mm-hmm. And then when I couldn't quite maybe verbalize it, being able to draw it.
Yeah.
I've never done that, because usually I just give up on myself, or I just tell people, you know, never mind.
Right, you don't even say it. So for the people that maybe watch this, maybe your friends or family or whomever, that we did an object tactile experience where she was blindfolded and received objects that she didn't know what they were. And of course, she figured it out, I'm sure, when she felt them, and had an experience with each one. And then when it was time for her to explain her situation or what she felt, or what the sensations that were coming up for her, sometimes it were hard to put into words. And I said, no problem.
Which was actually funny, because I was hoping that we would just not do it. But then when you're like, brought out the pens and everything.
Brought out markers and paper, and I asked her to draw what she was experiencing, and said, because that allows people to go into the right brain instead of the left brain. Sometimes the left brain doesn't have concepts and words for what we're experiencing in our bodies. So we go to the right brain. There's many different ways to do that, but art is definitely one. Yay, so that was what you enjoyed, and that was fantastic. So that was our first thing that we did. And what was the most challenging thing?
Breathing, remembering how to breathe when put in situations that I like, that are foreign or I'm uncomfortable with. Meaning the last consent game that we did, the coming and going and stopping.
Mm-hmm. So that one is particularly, we stood on opposite sides of the large room, and she had three commands that she could use, which was come, stop, and go away. So to be able to do that to each other, breathing is hard, because there's a lot of things happening, like you're having to maintain internal control with what's happening within yourself, and also tell somebody else something else to do. So there's a lot of layers to that. And what, let's see the next question. Can you think of anything?
The hand thing was really uncomfortable, hard time, but then when we did it again and I practiced breathing, I was able to, we were able to touch, that was the longest we touched.
That's right.
All day.
That's true.
That was pretty cool.
So the you can see how breathing can make a huge difference in sessions and
huge.
Touch and in our relationships. And in, instead of panicking, we can introduce breathing to our to all of it. And that activity, what it was, is I would introduce like my hand in a certain way, and she was either to mirror it, like or like match what I did or mirror it. So if I put my finger out, it was like her finger was to meet mine. And so we began there, and then of course moved into other things. And so, yeah. And there was there were emotions, there were sensations and feelings that came up that
oh yeah
that you know. And it's amazing because we established right from the beginning that CK is really good at sensing what's happening in her body, in your body, right? You're able to like feel like your legs doing something or like the energy moving up and your throat and your face and your neck, like all of these things. Even if you were just touching an object, it has a direct effect on the rest of your body.
Well, and then the energy on our hands, that was, I don't even know how to describe that.
So yeah, so if you take someone's hand, yours, maybe even with your own hand, I think it works. And yeah, it works, I can feel it.
Crazy.
It's, you know, so often we just move in and like grab someone's hand when we want to hold their hand, but if you just do that, you can feel the like there's an energy that comes out of the palms and you can play with it even. And so you have to experience there is a force field around you.
Yeah.
Protective force field. So you can play with that a little and yeah, greater sensations. So thank you for our first day.
Yay.
What are you looking forward to tomorrow?
Breathing.
Breathing. Okay.